Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the Sheraman Law Classes. Friends, today our topic is related with the Control of Narcotics Substances Act 1997. I shall also discuss with you about the narcotics, the psychotropic substances, and the controlled drugs or dangerous drugs in this class. So friends, this act was passed in 1997, and then it is the law related with the narcotics and all the matters connected with narcotics. With this act also, the rules for narcotics was also passed, and that is also called the Narcotics Rules 1997. Before to start this act in detail, it is necessary that I shall talk with you about the narcotics, psychotropic substances and drugs. The controlled drugs. Narcotics are the substances which are basically extracting from certain plants which are cultivating at various places of the world, and that drugs are using by the people just to change their mood and their perception. And it directly affects the human mind and brain of the person. At initial stage, the person who is the user of drugs or drug addicts or the person who is using narcotics or psychotropic substances, he feels happy and his mood is changing, his perception is changing. But gradually he became habitual, and the dose of narcotics or psychotropic substances increasing with the passage of time. Not only the narcotics or all the intoxicating material affecting the human brain, mind, but it also affects the central nervous system of a person. And when the central nervous system became loose, the coordination of it with the muscles is also losing its effect, and thereby causing for that person problems related with his movement and his activeness. When he is using that intoxicating material, he seems very active. But when the intoxicating effect is decreasing gradually, so then his body starting pain and aching, and thereby he prefers to make rest, and he goes for such place where he can sleep and where he can rest for long time. So basically all the intoxicating materials, including controlled substances, psychotropic substances and controlled drugs, they are very dangerous for human health, and it is also dangerous for the human life. And its prolonged use may cause to end the life of a person. So for this purpose, it is banned all over the world. Before this act of 1997, there were some other laws relating with narcotics were in field both in India and Pakistan. In 1878, the Offian Act was passed, and that act was not only promulgated in India, but it was also promulgated in Pakistan, and still that act is in field. Then in 1930, the Dangerous Drugs Act was passed in India. And the same act was also promulgated in Pakistan when Pakistan came into being, and that act is still existing. Similarly, other ordinances and acts were also enacted to control the narcotics and to curb the drug pushers and smugglers. During the era of General Ziaul Haq, an ordinance was passed that was known as Had, Prohibition of Had Ordinance. And according to that ordinance, not only the drinking were prohibited, but also the narcotics substances including chas, bhang, opium and heroin were banned in that act. And that ordinance is known as the Prohibition of Had Ordinance 1997. Not only that ordinance was promulgated during that era, but other ordinance related with Hadood or Had, that were four in number, that ordinances were promulgated during that time. The culture of narcotics became very common in Pakistan after the Soviet Union invasion on Afghanistan. Because Pakistan was a nearby country with Afghanistan, and we have a very long border, that is 1800 kilometers long. Due to this border, the drug pushers smuggling that drugs from Afghanistan to Pakistan, and it destroy our culture. And that the not only our culture, the heroin came to Pakistan, but Kalashnikov culture also came to Pakistan, and drugs became very common in Pakistan. So for this purpose, it was considered as a very serious matters, and governments started to take strict measures to curb the drug pushers. The UNO also considered this matter very serious, not only in Pakistan but in the entire world, and various conventions of UNO were held. In 1988 in Geneva, the UNO held a convention in which all the countries of the world participated. And during that convention, the UNO stressed the need to curb the narcotics from the entire world. And this process was also continued during various regimes of Pakistan. And ultimately, in 1997, during the Prime Minister Muhammad Nawaz Sharif, the Parliament passed this law, that is known as the Control of Narcotics Substances Act 1997. This is a complete law. It is also a substantive law as well as procedural law. Before this act, all the other laws relating with control of narcotic substances, drugs and psychotropic substances were substantive law, and there was no procedure prescribed for it. But for the first time, this act provided both procedure and as well as substantive law at the same time. And under this act, various courts, special courts were established in the whole country, and special judges were set in that courts, and still this law is considered to be the supreme law related with the narcotics in Pakistan. So this was about a brief introduction regarding the control substances and psychotropic substances. Now, there are certain sections which are very famous and which are very important. So I shall discuss all that important sections with you. Let's talk about section 1. Section 1 of this act is related with the extent, and it is talking about how this act is extended in the whole Pakistan. Then we have section 2. Section 2 is related with definition, and you may know that in all laws, in all statutes, always section 2 is related with definition. So section 2 defines the opium, that what is opium, what is cannabis plant, what is narcotics, and similarly what are coca bush, cocaine, etc. So all these things are discussed in section 2 of this act. After that, the other section which is famous and very important, that is section 4 of this act. Section 4 is basically related with the narcotics plant, and it prohibits the cultivation of narcotics plant. And similarly, punishment for the same act has been described in Section 5 of this act, which is 7 years punishment for the person who cultivates the narcotic plants or gather leaves of narcotic plants. Then Section 6, 7 and 8, these are very important sections, and all these Section 6, 7 or, and 8 are related with the prohibition of narcotics, possession of narcotics, import of narcotics, export of narcotics, financing of narcotics, trafficking of narcotics, and all the other related matters with narcotics which the smugglers carry from one place to another. So all these sections, Section 7, 6, 8 are dealing all these matters. Then the most important section in this act is Section 9, and it is important in the sense because it provides punishment which are related with the matters discussed in Section 6, 7 and 8. So it describes punishment for the same, and basically Section 9 is then divided into 4 categories, that is 9A, 9B and 9C. And then 9C is further divided into 2 subclasses. One is in which the drug is less than 10 kg, and the other class is related when the drug quantity or control substances quantity increases than 10 kg. So let's talk about 9A. Basically 9A relates with the trafficking, financing or possession of narcotics when the quantity of narcotics substances is less than 100 gram or 100 gram. So such amount or such quantity of narcotics comes under the category of 9A, and punishment for the same is 2 years. A person who deal with it. Then we have 9B. 9B, when the drug pushers possess, finance or trafficking the narcotic substances in which the quantity of narcotics is between 100 gram and 1 kilogram. So then the punishment for the same is prescribed is 7 years. And the same is not falling under the non-prohibitory clause, and bail may be granting in such 9A and 9B as well. Then we have 9C. When the quantity exceeds then 1 kg, so then it attracts Section 9. And when the quantity increasing from 1 kg, so then it is a big offense, and punishment is also increasing. It may vary from 14 years to 25 years or life imprisonment or also death penalty. But as I told earlier, 9C we can easily divide into 2 classes. 9C, when the quantity is more than 1 kg but less than 10 kg. So then the maximum punishment for that is 14 years. But when the quantity increases from 10 kg, so So then the punishment is also increasing, and it may vary. It depends on the quality, quantity of substances, and it may vary from 14 years to life imprisonment or even death penalty. It depends on the quality, quantity of narcotics. In this connection, that how much sentence shall be awarded to the offender regarding the quality, quantity of narcotics, which varies from case to case. So for this purpose, a judgment was passed in the Lahore High Court under the guideline of very famous judge and very leading judge of Pakistan, known as Kosa Sahab. That is very important judgment. In this judgment, the honorable judge made a table, and in that table the narcotics were categorized according to the quality and according to the quantity. And that judgment is known as PLD. I repeat the citation, PLD 2009, page number 362. That is Ghulam Murtaza case. Ghulam Murtaza case. So this is very famous case and very famous citation. In this case, a table was dropped, and according to that table, the narcotics were categorized. And it is mentioned clearly that what shall be the punishment for chars, for heroin, for bhang, for opium. A table was dropped, and still this is a very famous judgment, and courts are adopting the sentencing policy according to this judgment. Suppose, in according to this judgment, if 1 kg chars is recovered from an accused person and he is male, so then 4.5 year punishment is there. But if 1 kg heroin is recovered from a male person, so then 6 years punishment is there. Similarly, when a lady is involved and 1 kg chars is recovered from her possession, that is chars, so then 3.5 year punishment is there for such lady. So this is very important judgment, and the lawyers who are related with narcotics, they shall study or must study this judgment as well. Then the other sections which are important, that is section 14. Section 14 is related with the association, aiding and abetment of with the drug pushers. And punishment for the same is prescribed in section 15, which is 5 years. Then the other important section in this act, that is section 19. Section 19 is related with the forfeiture of assets of an offender, means a person who is involved in the business of narcotics and he is arresting, and then his property traced out by the ANF authorities or police, and it comes in the knowledge of the court that that property has ascertained through the money of narcotics. So then the court has power to attach that property, confiscate that property, and issue order for its forfeiture. So this power is there under section 19 of the Narcotic Substances Act. Then section 20 is important. Section 20 is related to issue search warrant by the court. The court, the special court, the special judge has power to issue search warrant for the arrest of any individual on the request of police. Then we have section 21 in it, giving power to the police to seize, search and seize narcotics, and also to arrest any individual without any warrant. So this section 21 is giving power to the police to act, to do any action regarding with narcotics against the accused person without taking any warrant from the court. Then section 25 is also very important, and section 25 is dealing that the government officials, the police officials, are very good persons to establish their case, and they may consider to be as a good evidence, because when the cases of drug narcotics are registering, so people are not supporting the police because they are afraid from the drug pushers. So that's the reason they are not recording their statement. So in such eventuality, police are considered, police or ANF authorities are considered to be the best evidence and the best persons to record their evidence in the courts. Actually, when this act was passed, so a force was also constituted, and that force is known as ANF. The job of ANF is to arrest the drug pushers. So when this force is arresting an individual, then they have power to record their statement regarding the arrest of that individual as a witness. And then they can come to the court and tender their statement in the court. Similarly, police has also power to arrest individual according to this act, as per 1997 rules of this act. So the police may also record their statement in the court after arresting such individual. So section 25 of this act is very important. Then we have section 32. Section 32 is related with the related vehicles or vessels which are captured from the drug pushers. So section 32 says that when any vehicle or vessel captured by the ANF authorities or police authorities shall not be confiscated when it's proved to the court that the owner had no knowledge regarding that, means he has no conscious knowledge, and without his knowledge his vehicle or vessel has been used. So this act is related with the conspiration. And similarly, whenever any lawyer is moving any application par superdari, so this is needed that he must study section 32. Then section 74 is also related, so I shall also talk about section 74 at this stage. Section 74 says regarding superdari that whenever the proceedings is in court and the trial is in progress, so no vehicle shall be granted till the conclusion of the trial to any person who apply to get his vehicle on interim custody through superdari. So both section 32 and 72 are interconnected. After all these important sections, now I move to another important section, that is section 45. Section 45 is related with the jurisdiction, and it says that special courts shall be constituted according to this act, and that courts shall be called special courts, and it shall work in the entire country. So for this purpose, courts were established. And not only special courts were established, but this power has been also granted to the district and session judge. he may also try such offenses when the police arrested accused person. So they produce such individual to the court of session judges or additional session judges. So both special court and session courts have exclusive power and jurisdiction to entertain the matter related with narcotics. Then we have section 46. Section 46 is related with the special courts and then the appointment of judges, and it says that the judge who is working as a presiding officer in the special court, he shall be the judge of level of district and session judge or additional district and session judge, and with the consultation of the high court, the federal government may appoint any judge who having the qualification to be additional session judge or district and session judge as the judge of special court. So this is about section 46. Then we have another important section, that is section 48. It is related with appeal, and it says that any judgment or any order passed by the court of narcotics, special court or session court related with narcotics matter, that may be appealable, and we may approach against that order or judgment to the Honorable High Court, and at least two judges of the High Court will decide the matter. So it is important that after challenging the order, two judges of the High Court, this is a very important point, that two judges of High Court shall decide the fate of that order or judgment on appeal. So this is the reason that when we move to High Court, whether we are challenging a judgment or any order, even bail order, so this section is there. Then another section, that is 51. Section 51 is also important. In section 51 of the Narcotics Act says that bail shall not be granted to a person when the quantity exceeds from 1 kg, or when the prescribed amount is exceeding, where the punishment is 14 years or life imprisonment. So when the quantity increasing from 1 kg, so normally this act bans to grant bail to such individual, such accused person under section 51. So this is very important section, and that's the reason that high courts are very reluctant, high courts and session court, to grant bail in 9C when the quantity exceeds from 1 kg, and still they consider the matter up to borderline, which is 1215 gram, that is the limit. But when that borderline is crossing, so then courts are not granting bail in such eventualities. Then we have another important two sections, that is section 51 and section 52. And all these, both these sections are dealing with the drug addicts, their rehabilitation in the society, their health care, and their education, etc. And it says that all the drug addicts shall hold a card which is issued by the federal government, and this is also the responsibility of the federal government to rehabilitate such individual who are drug addicts. Section 52 is dealing with for the establishment of various centers in the country whereby such addicts shall be treated. So both these sections are related with the drug addicts. Then we have the other important section, which already I discussed with you, that is section 74, and that is related with the matter, especially connected with Superdari. So I have already discussed that section, and it is connected with section 32 of the Narcotics Substances Act. So friends, this was our today topic, in which we discussed the Control of Narcotics Act 1997 in detail. Next, my lecture is related with how to deal the narcotics case in the court and how to take bail in the narcotics case in the court. I shall discuss that topic with you. Please subscribe my this channel and also push bell icon button so my notification shall reach to you. Thank you so much.